The Apprentice. Erin, great seeing you.
Great to see you.
So let's talk a little bit about today. What can we expect, you think? A presidential Donald Trump or an attack Donald Trump against what he calls Hillary Clinton's problems?
I think he is going to be extremely presidential. Look, this speech isn't going to be a reaction to Hillary Clinton yesterday. It is going to be a full-on attack on the true Hillary Clinton and who she is and what she stands for. Donald Trump has a lot of great things going on his campaign right now. The meeting with evangelicals yesterday was absolutely amazing and forward-thinking, and now has some great people involved, like Michelle Bachmann. His website is up and running and beautiful. People can now receive text updates. Here, there's options on there to donate to the campaign. So he has amazingly wonderful things going on, and he's got great things to talk about. And something he's really going to spend a lot of time talking about is Hillary Clinton. So he will be presidential, he will be prepared, and he will be professional.
One of the things that in the past, you know, people have noted about him is that he'll bring something up about Hillary Clinton, but then he'll kind of veer off to other issues like Judge Curiel, which took, you know, 2 weeks of the oxygen of the discussion when, you know, maybe there were other issues to be talking about, but he was laser focused on Judge Curiel. Is that something that we're going to see in the future? I mean, can he stick to the message of a presidential campaign?
Absolutely. He has a great team behind him, and there has been a bit of a shakeup, but all is for the best. He's doing well. He's refocused. He has great people behind him, and he's a very smart individual. I think perfectly ready today, perfectly prepared, staying focused, staying on message, because he has a message to deliver.
So let's talk a little bit about things are going great and he's prepared. When you look at some of the numbers, and he's down on some of the national polls against Hillary Clinton, six or more points. But then if you look at some of the negatives, 70% negative among the general population, 89% negative in the Latino community. How does he go forward when he has such high negatives? 70% in the general population, almost 90% in the Latino community.
But those are just some of the polls. There are other ones to look at, like he's on par in Pennsylvania, likely that he's going to win Virginia. So there are other focuses. And some of these polls are landlines of people that, you know, aren't really necessarily in touch or not necessarily even going to vote. So, you know, I think that those polls don't really say a lot about the truth of what's going on out there.
Mark Cuban tweeted something on Tuesday that's getting a lot of attention, saying Trump doesn't have the money or the liquidity to fund his own campaign. What's the reality here, you think?
Well, there's a long reality, and I'll make it short. Mark Cuban wants to be Donald Trump. He had a failed reality show, kind of like The Apprentice. He's also, you know, a well-spoken, well-heeled man of means. I think perhaps he wants to be president. But you know what? Maybe they can work together and work it all out.
Erin Elmore, thank you for being with me. It's a pleasure to see you. Appreciate your time.